Good day, Canada and hockey fans in the United States, Newfoundland. I'm Unsilent, and we're on the air with NHL 94, the 2021 mod edition. Okay, originally from the year 1993 for the Sega Genesis and Sega CD and SNES and PC as well. This is one of, if not the greatest hockey game of all time. Of course, on the channel over Christmas, I showed you guys what is the worst hockey game of all time in actual ice hockey 2. And today I present the polar opposite. Of course, the NHL season is just about to begin in, what, 9 days on January 13th, I believe. Unless things have changed between when I recorded this a week before you see it and when you're watching it. So I'm hoping not. Hopefully we get back to some puck, a 56-game NHL season inside of four unique divisions, specially done for just this occasion. So it'll be interesting to see how that goes. Of course, my team, the good old Detroit Red Wings, not likely to do too well this season, but that's okay, as long as the lottery doesn't screw us again. I mean, who does a draft lottery where you're more likely to pick fourth than you are in any of the top three spots? I mean, who does a draft lottery system like that? What a dumb system. Thank you for ruining it, Edmonton. It's all on the Oilers. It ruined the NHL. Alright, so we're going to play a couple games of NHL 94. This is the, as I mentioned, it's the 2021 mod. This I'm playing is the preseason edition, the full season edition by The Sauce over on the NHL 94 forums. He will almost certainly have the full version out by the 13th, if not on, or slightly after the 13th, but anyway, I think we should get started. Let's see, line changes to auto, and I think we are good to go for a little NHL 94 action. Of course, the Wings are rated lower than the Ducks. They're probably the lowest rated team in the league. Granted, this is considerably better. I played the NHL 94 Rewind at my cousin's place on Christmas Eve. We weren't locked down in Ontario then. We're locked down now, but we weren't locked down then. And so I played it there. I got the crappy controller. You know that thing that happens? You know, you guys do it. Admit it. Have company over and, let's play this and, Oops, ignore the fact that I just handed you the crappy controller. Oh, shit. Hit him! Up to Bert. Over to Mantha. I'm just trying to get it in on Gibby. That's our problem, is we have to go up against Gibby. That's not going to be easy. It's never easy. What is it with Ducks goaltenders against the Red Wings, right? Get another whistle here, because we got two wings right in front. Yeah, take that. Have played a little bit of NHL 94 Rewind. Oh! Let's go move D-Boss up. Try and find someone in front. Nope, we're not going to. I thought Mantha in front was where the pass was going to go, but I would be wrong. I thought the pass to, I think that was Larkin that was, was streaking in the slot there. Ow, off the side of the cage there. Everybody's kind of crowding in behind there. Oh, over the cage. Bounce it off the back of the net. Oh, that was a two-line pass. In the old NHL, that would have been a whistle to play dead. Nice stop. Yeah, two-line pass, so I passed it from inside my own blue line, and oh, get him out of the way. What the? How did Rackle get two assists on that play? What the hell's that? The one-timer. If anybody could, you know, get in position to receive a one-time pass. That would be... Oh, here we go. Robbie Fabry. Trying to go in without support. This is what, Stetcher 70? And that's the end of the first period. Quick first period! Annoying first period, but a quick first period. Scoring was a hell of a lot easier in the NHL 94 Rewind version of it. Granted, the NHL 94... My impression of the NHL 94 Rewind version of it might be skewed because I had to... And you scored double on timer. Of course you score on the one timer in this game. That might have been skewed because I had to play on the, playing at my cousin's place Christmas Eve. Just playing on, you know, the shitty spare controller. Everyone has that. It's like, I'm gonna play with a good controller, you guest shall play with a shitty controller, and I will reap the benefits. Oh, we're gonna get a benefit, we're gonna get a highlight from Calgary and Chicago! Comes in, spins around, and, I was gonna say, I thought Nylander was out for the season, but... Oh, we've got another highlight. Duncan Keith. Up to whoever the hell 8 is. He spins, and he's twirling, twirling, twirling towards freedom! Oh. Are they gonna be able to do anything with this? Oh, here's Taves. Gives it up at the line. I don't know who anyone in Calgary is. A lot of twirling towards freedom happening. Taves. He'll bring it up ice across the blue line into the slot. He scores! A taser from Jonathan Taves. Can't be Canadian and not have that line just ready to go at any moment, right? All right, let's see if we can't salvage something out of the second stanza. D-Boss. Finds Mantha, gets checked down in the corner. Rackle well offside. Didn't need the new offside rule. That wouldn't have saved him. What? Does somebody want to stop him? Somebody want to make a check there? Except for you, Phil, because you slashed the man, apparently. That did not help. Alright, well, PK1 is out. Grice has it. Oh, he's Luke Glendening. Up to Franz Nielsen. Back to Glendening. Oh, glove saved by Gibby. Blasted in from the point and block. Nemeth gives it away. Got to rely on Mark Stahl to try and pick it up. Okay, what? Well, Glendening had an attempt there. Passed back to absolutely no one. Interfered with at the line by Glendening. Luke Glendening's the star of the team right now. Here comes Hronik trying to help. Don't help too much, you might get another slashing call. I thought I was aiming at Nielsen, but I guess not. Ah, got for the slot, and that didn't work. I feel like I was just, rather than checking him, I felt like Stahl was just pushing him faster. Wasn't really a check happening there. Much spinning was done there. Up to Bertuzzi. In the slot for... Oh, Larkin couldn't get it off in time. Dump it down. Nobody can touch up for the icing. That went well. Game stats. They got one more shot in that frame. Nobody's getting any shots. This has been an affair that you would expect from two shitty franchises like the Wings and Ducks currently are. Just really turn off sides off. It's killing me right now. Offside. Gave him a few extra seconds on that call. You ought to be faster with the reactions, ref. Lost the puck. Now what? Oh, it's an icing. Okay, good. I thought they were going to call Phil for the interference. Flings it on net. Rebound! No. There's the Kaiser up to Bert. Oh, Bert sent it to the bench. Where's the roughing miner? There's the Kaiser. Big save by Grice. Man, can you guys stay on side, please? All right, Fabry in the second unit. Off of Zdina's skate. Up to Nemestikov. He fell down. Fabry fell down. Somebody get Glendening out there. Just 2 minutes to go. Here goes Nemestikov. And, Gibbon. Or Gibson. That's a Gibbons. The hell's that? Stetcher finds Nemestikov. Another one-timer from Zadina foiled. First unit. Rebound! And Bert can't put it home. Swear the scoring was easier in 94. Rewind. Oh, second unit is Fabry & Co. Now we got just a bunch of hammering happening in the boards. All right, Zadina. Phil, you got it. Do it yourself. Well, that's not going to work, but it was a valiant effort. Gibson gets the shutout. Rackle with 2 assists on 1 goal. Gets the second star of the game. And then Getzlaff gets the third star for the goalman. It should have been our boy, Glendening. I don't know how does stats Glendening didn't get anything. It was not a high scoring game, was it? Or a high offense game either. 13, a total of 24 shots. You expect video game numbers. We finally got the one-timer count going, but not a particularly hot affair, so. Ah, well, is what it is. All right, who wants to do another game? Yeah. I'm trying to think, what did we do with NHL 95 last month, right? Because we've been going through all these classic hockey games. We did Tampa and, what, Vegas? So I'm just trying to remember who else is at the top of the list that I don't hate. Could do. Just trying to think, who is at or near the top there? Dallas is there. We don't have to pair them off against, pair off against Washington, but because of the new playoff format, it doesn't have to be. You know, it's just 4 divisions. It's not 2 conferences anymore. So it could be... I mean, it doesn't necessarily have to be a Western versus Eastern Conference team. But it could be. Because here you've got an Eastern Division team against a Central Division team. I think Dallas is in the Central Division. Penalties on except offsides? Oh, hell, if I'm going to do that, I'm going to play as... Except I just turned off all my shit. All right, there. If I'm going to be playing with that sort of no offsides advantage, I'm going to play as Washington. Which is a good call, because they have the overall advantage. Ron Barfamy sold out American Airlines Center, sold out relative terms. They are supposed to be allowing people into the building in Dallas, last I read. Now, again, that's probably changed since I recorded it, so, and may change between now and, or I guess when I recorded it, and when you're watching it, and the start of the season, so. Of course, we've got the worst goalie. Alright, let's give her a go. Well, Detroit was beating Seattle. I don't know if you saw that at the bottom. I should have played Seattle. I don't know anyone on... I know, like, a couple of players. Like, I know that's Carlson. I know that's an Ovechkin fella. Let's go. I couldn't score for shit with Detroit, but with Ovi, I score on my first shot. Of course. I've got Ovi. It's like a goddamn cheat code. Oh, I thought I was about to score two there. Alright. Let's see what that was. Because Kuznetsov is 92? Big rebounds. Oh! Ovi with the big defensive play. Ovi watched D3 over the Christmas break before the season started and decided, yes, I've got to pick up that trash in front of the goal. Some big hitting happening there. Not effective hitting, but big hitting nonetheless. All right, let's try and... Gotta bring it. Oh, big hit. Headed on by Samsonov. Oh, here we go. Back to the point and give it away. Give it away, give it away, give it away now. Like it's a Chili Pepper song, of course. Bring it in. Dump pass. Looking for someone in front. We'll find someone at the point who is not inside the blue line. Oh wait, I turned off offsides, didn't I? Well, in that case, keep up the pressure. Let's go, come on. Just hold it down for the end of the frame and there we go. One more frame in the books. Hey, I've got a lead now. Hey, Detroit's leading Seattle 5-3. I don't know if you saw it at the bottom of the screen there. I can't believe that Detroit's leading a game either. This could be a long, long season. Long. Montreal and Winnipeg playing in the Canadian division. New York and Colorado not in the same division. Toronto went into Minnesota, and then we'll have to take a two-week break before they go back to Toronto. Oh, we've got Boston and Nashville. Well, that was quick. Oh, Pasternak. I was paying attention to who had the puck. I was expecting him to just come in and go bloop, but it's Pasternak, so of course. Oh, there was going to be a highlight there. I skipped it. I was a little slow on the draw, including there, because Dallas won the draw. Ovi with the hit. Big one-timer, but stopped by Bishop. Sagan hit, or almost hit. Oh, down goes Ben. I was dancing around. I thought I could pull that one off. Radulov taking advantage of the lack of offsides. Radulov rocked. You like that alliteration? One-timer and stopped by Bishop. Oh. Oh, down to us. Oh no, we lost Ovechkin for the period. There's two calls on that play. As they was. Oh, they only gave us the injuring one because there was a delayed penalty before that. Ah, oh, there's the slashing Sagan going for two for slashing. There we go. I knew there were two calls on the play. Two separate infractions, two separate penalties. So we've got a 2 minutes. The 5-on-3. Problem. No Ovechkin. Dumps it down. Won't be ice. Bishop's going to move it fast. Oh, he put it through the glass off the back end. Oh, you're going to make the glass breaks and we have to start from outside the zone? Really? Trap. Let's move this up the ice. One timer. Oh. Big save, Ben Bishop. Now what? A charging minor from Sakara? Now we've got... I don't know how the game's going to handle this. So we've got... In real hockey, yeah. So we'll have... Face-off as my guy gets dumped in front. Yeah, so it'll be, So the 5-on-3 would have been... There's too much power play time on there. The 5-on-3 should have been ticking. Like, this extra penalty should have been ticking concurrent. I was hoping there was somebody over there. So I could one-time it, but yeah. So in real hockey, what would happen there, if you're not familiar, is... Okay, so that 25 seconds... That last 25 seconds of the 5-on-3 initially, that should have been kept as 5-on-3, and then one of the players would come back on, and then it would run from there as the remaining minute 35 would be 5-on-4. Now they left it 5-on-3 until the 25 seconds expired, and then it started the 5-on-4 for the remaining chunk of time. Oh, there's a goal, Nathan MacKinnon. I shouldn't be surprised. That'll seal the win for the Colorado Avalanche. Pick up Carlson. Alright. Let's see what we could do. Because Nets off. Round back. There should have been Ovi. There's Ovi. He's power play quarterback. And he's wrecking everyone too. See, it doesn't work so well in this. Oh, off the iron. That could be critical. Oh! Retaliatory post attack! And we score Nick Backstrom, with assists from Carlson and Samsonov, and that will make it a 2-0 game. Hey, there you go. This could be a preview of the semifinals right here. Oh, Ilya. Son, you gotta be careful with that puck. Radulov halves the lead. Because Samsonov flopped like a fish out of water. Okay, oop, Ovi lost it. And picks it back up again. He'll just rip it through the entirety of the earth. Carlson scores! John Carlson. Let's go. 3-1 Caps. By the way, have you seen their new Screaming... I'm sure you have. Their new Screaming Eagle reverse retro jersey. Isn't that fire? I love that thing. Well, Ben. Glove save, Samsonov. Oh, across the ice. But stoned by Ben Bishop. Fired around. And Samsonov will pick it up. And freeze it. Gotta get the first unit out. Kuznetsov? Oh, they pulled their goalie? Oh, it's blocked down in front. Kuznetsov! Can't get it across and now... Oh, this isn't gonna be pretty. Now we got somebody going down for two. It'll be Kuznetsov. 2 minutes for charging. He is a little hopped up at times, isn't he? Got a little extra pep in his step. Dump it down. That'll be it, the Caps. In the road unis, nothing wrong with those. Since the Caps went retro, they've been looking good. How about those Screaming Eagle reverse retros? Fire. I like those. Granted, everything's pretty good compared to the Wings one. Your 3 stars the game! The third star from the Dallas Stars is Alex Radulov. Then it was what, I missed who was number two. Was it Backstrom or Kuznetsov? And then John Carlson, first star of the game. No Ovi, though. Comes in, scores the first goal of the game. Let's take a look at this. We did outshoot Dallas there. Didn't convert on the power play, unfortunately. But hey, is what it is. Couldn't convert on a one-timer. I'll be damned. Of all the things. Could not convert on the one-timer. Carlson had a couple of assists and the goal. Okay, yeah, no, that makes sense. I didn't realize he had assist on the Ovechkin goal in the first minute. But, yeah, no, he had a... Oh, yeah, 3 points off of 3 goals. Well, I mean, it's Carlson, right? I mean, Ovi's great. Don't get me wrong. Ovi's a very good player. But you don't sleep on John Carlson. Then again, Mike Green would have been the star of the team for a little while there, too. And then he just sort of fell off the face of the earth. Fortunately, Carlson was there to pick up the slack, but hey. I used to play blue line growing up, so of course I'm going to focus on the defenseman, right? Hey, okay, so one's a not-so-great game, but a pretty good recovery there. As I mentioned, of course you could catch this game on the NHL 94 forums. Hit the forum, NHL94.com, go to the forum, scroll down to the ROMs part, and this one's under Genesis ROMs, by the sauce, of course. This is, what, the second 2021 modded classic hockey game that we have taken a look at so far. I want to say this season, because we've already looked at the NHL 95 one. We'll call it this season. Do have a few more we want to take a look at as this year rolls on. The best way to see those is by hitting that subscribe button, and you'll be here when we drop the puck on another month with more classic hockey. But until we see you for that, I'm Unsilent. Thanks very much for joining me. Like the video if you liked it. Subscribe if you're new. Share on social media. Follow on social media. The social media handle is Unsilent on Air. And that is for Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and Tumblr. And don't forget, you can check out some classic and not so classic hockey in the playlist. It's on the screen in the description down below. And more videos anytime on the channel page. And until the next time, I'm Unsilent. Thanks very much for joining me. Like, share, subscribe. And we will see you next time.